family is never tied to anybody that left. The Bible said that they came out from us, that it might be made manifest that they were not of us. For had they been of us, no doubt they would have continued with us. People leave you because they're not joined to you. And if they're not joined to you, you get super glue and you can't make them stay. Let them go. And it doesn't mean that Oprah was a bad person.
On day three, y'all, preparation for Crave. Everybody look tired. You see, everybody just tired.
Come to Crave. This is the last day. You can't come all day. Shame on you, but you can do this
day. Look at the kids. They so tired today.
Bro.
But look, we on day three, so that means we almost through it.
Trying to help you get better.
Mm-hmm. And because your life is not based off the word, it's based off the world, ooh, you keep bearing what God wants to use.
Yeah, I hear that. I hear that.
And you're so busy. Bring your mic to me. You're so busy trying to impress people that don't like you. Ooh. Can't do nothing for you. So if you're really gonna do some work to get what you carry, that's right. You're gonna dig, get what you bury, make a plan. You ready?
Mm-hmm.
If you're gonna really do work, you gotta take some stuff off.
Come on, take it off.
Watch this. You can't be worried about what else gets dirty. Trying to get what you can bury.
You gotta get
seven. Separate. It's gonna take a while. Some of y'all, juniors and seniors, high school, and it's been buried since they touched you when you were 9.
Reverend, help us.
Some of y'all, about to graduate high school, buried since they told you it was gonna be just like your no good daddy. They told you. Pastor Wesley, don't fire me, all right? They told you that he was gonna be a hoe like your mama. And they used that word. Cause old people don't know what that means. They told you you weren't gonna amount to nothing cause you ain't nothing. And you believed them. So you took what was worthy and worthwhile and considered it worthless. And you buried it here. Being who God has called you to be. And you've been crying tears. You've been doing things you know you shouldn't be doing. Trying to bury the gift God has given you. And you're mad because you see other people succeeding. And the whole time you hurt him. And the truth of the matter is, somebody in here, like, God, why me? Why they had to touch me? Why my family? Why did I have to go through this? Why am I crying these tears? Why am I going through all this pain, all this struggle? God, why me? And the Lord tells you, I'm coming back. I'm coming back. And I don't care how deep your talent is. Understand it to you. I'm coming back. And I want to see what you know, what I've given you. Say, but God, it takes work to get all this out. And God, my hands are dirty. So I got what you've given me. Now I'm dirty. What do I do next? God says, I got something to take care of that. Give me the water.
Behind you, God. Behind you.
Open the water.
That's it.
Yeah. God says, I was about to drink. God says, I got something that will wash this dirt away.
Yeah.
Come on, God. Wash it away.
And the more you get involved in youth ministry,
come on.
That's it.
The more you dive into your word,
amen.
The more you trust God,
yeah.
He'll pour his word over you. And he washes you. Jesus is the only one that can take your black sin, dip it in his red blood, and you come out white as snow. And he deserves glory. He deserves honor. He deserves praise. I dare you to shake the foundation of this place tonight. And give God true worship. Not your hand claps, but your mouth. Your worship. Your worship. Your worship. The Bible says that everything that hath breath, praise the Lord. And everything that hath breath, praise the Lord. And everything that hath breath, praise the Lord. So anyone can praise God. But it takes somebody with a relationship, somebody who knows who he is to worship him. And you may not know everything about him, but what you do know is he washed you and he made you whole. And I dare you to worship him right here. Because you love him. Everything else can wait. Worship him, children. Come on, worship him. This is your worship. This is your moment. I don't care what it looks like. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on.
One thing I believe is, I believe in showing love. Love isn't, if somebody says that they love you and it's just verbal, it's perversion and it's lust. But true evidence of love is when you show it. All right, check this out. One of the greatest ways that I want to challenge all of y'all to do, he ain't asked for this, he ain't say nothing about this, we ain't never talked about this, have we? All right? I remember a couple years ago, we went to his church, and we were just, I don't know what we were there for.
He was exiting.
Yeah, because I was going
to. Yeah, he was getting ready to leave his church, getting ready to move to Nashville. And
I requested you send me money.
Hey, we got a little technical.
This but is, I sent this you what something, we did. I just figured it out. We took up, how much money was that?
$300.
We took up $300 from his kids, and they just blessed him with it. They just brought it and started dropping it at his feet. And I'm,
here we go.
And so this is what I want to do. I don't know
dead
what
serious.
Y'all.
No, this is
I'm being dead serious. If you have it, because y'all love him, so love is what love does.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I just want us to bless Pastor Purvey tonight. If you don't have cash, let's hit Cash App.
Yeah.
Tonight, I want him, whatever you, what the measure of what he's poured into your life will never compare to what we put in this box.
And let me add to that, though. Amen. If you don't have something now,
that's it.
Yeah,
that's
it. I challenge you. Don't just think this was the moment.
Right.
Yeah.
That you still have an opportunity on tomorrow or whenever that is to sow a seed. And watch this. If you put a buck down, it's not about the size.
That's
it's about your sacrifice.
That's right.
And so appreciate him through something that that he can go back home and help the twins with, right?
Yeah.
Do something for his wife. So I challenge you to sow something.
Yeah.
Yeah, we did. Yeah.
So let's do it. Let's do it.
It doesn't matter what that. Like you said, it doesn't matter about the size. It only matters about your heart. Now listen. Make sure you sow into seeds because watch this. Whenever you're going through something, you know who you can call.
Don't pass the $20 and go to the dollar. No.
Right.
Give a good seed.
Right. I'll give you an example tonight.
Right.
A dude called him right when we were pulling up. One of his teens called him and said, "Listen, I don't need nothing." He said, "What you need?" The dude said, "I need you to pray for me for guidance." Mm-hmm. Then the next thing out of his mouth was, "How much money you need?" Out of his mouth to the kid. Mm-hmm. So if he does it, I know Pastor Purvey does it for y'all.
But and not man, just I saw him feed
for
them.
Y'all, not just for y'all.
You saw what? He fed them this week. Mm-hmm. Oh, I was there. I saw it.
Oh, okay, well,
come on, chicken.
Come on. You know they don't feed the kids.
What's your name?
What's your name on Cash App? What's your name on Cash App?
Come on, bring your seed.
Bless you. Bless you.
Bro.
Somebody gave a 10.
Glory.
Oh, we said it wasn't about the
10.
What's your name on Cash App?
I don't have any cash.
So this wraps up the last and final day of the Crave student conference. This experience as a whole was amazing simply because I got to see some kids at a young age actually come to Jesus and accept Christ and see some kids leave it at the altar. I don't see that very often, especially not with our generation. So I'm really excited with the turnout that Crave had this year. I'm excited about every year that we have Crave, but being able to come back as a past leader and still come in and see how everything is still shifting and changing and how Robert Purvey is still pouring into these kids and letting the Lord use him at all, at any measure, and never letting these kids stop. I love it, because he poured into me. So, I'm excited. It's the last day of Crave, y'all. Well,
we sure.
So it's done.
We crying.
So yeah.
Wait, I can't
say this. Just had
to this gonna be the last on the Crave.
But until next year, though.
Until next year. I like that.
I like that. You ain't about nothing. You were just going down that
road. So, this the last day, and you haven't spoke on none of my vlogs, other than when you. And today, we're not gonna do it again. Say something to my vlog.
Hey, vlog.
I'm his favorite. He don't want to say nothing.
What am I saying, Sid?
Just say how Crave was a great experience. This is going on YouTube.
Crave was amazing. Sid is amazing because he gets all this. But I pray that through. All of that's been done this week, that somebody got closer to God in a more unique way, and you're living your best life. Because you ain't got no time for these people.
Living
my best life.
That's a wrap, y'all. Crave was amazing. Day three is over, so Crave is over. Kind of bittersweet.
All right,
y'all. Crave was amazing. This is all amazing. They're gonna see all this footage coming together soon. Cause I got a lot.
Yeah. I'm excited.
Got a lot. Y'all gonna see these kids coming to Jesus. They're gonna see it. All right, y'all. We out.